Hey, everybody. Adam Vabro here for another episode of Ask a Pro Anything, this time at home. And we've got a superstar that you might recognize, as he is a record 9-time Indian national champion, 4-time gold medalist at the Commonwealth Games, and recently crowned champion of the 2020 ITTF Challenge Plus Oman Open. It's India's own Sharath Kamal Achanta. Sharath, how you doing?
I'm fine, Adam. Thank you very much. Thanks for inviting me over for the first ever home video. So, yeah, I guess that's how it's going to be from now on until the circuit resumes. Yeah. But I hope you're doing fine. How are you coping up with the stuff there?
I'm good. I mean, I don't have a pink clock, so I'm a little bit jealous. But no, I'm doing well. I think our lives have become so dependent on the internet, and we can connect with the whole world, that it almost feels the same in that sense. How are you doing with everything in the quarantine?
India has been on a lockdown 1 week after I came back from Oman Open. So we were pretty much scared during the Oman Open if we could get back home, or if we got back home, do we have to go to the quarantine facility? You know, so these were issues which were troubling us or bothering us during the Oman Open. But yeah, I'm lucky enough to get back home, and I had to home quarantine myself for 28 days. That was the order given by my city municipal corporation. So they had come home because they knew that I had traveled. And they said I need to stay home for 28 days. So I couldn't step out. But anyways, there's nothing much to step out and do, because during the lockdown, just these regular supermarkets and pharmacies which are open. So we order online most of the stuff. So I haven't been out much though. So that's how it's been. It's been tough. I think the times are difficult times at this point of time. It's tough times for everybody. But I think we need to try to be positive, because there's so much of negativity and there's so much of anxiety. So I think that's very, very important to be more positive and look forward in doing some things in our regular day-to-day stuff.
Yeah, so, well, I have a few questions for you regarding that. What are you doing sort of as a professional athlete? Obviously, you can't have too many days off, because you'll lose your fitness. You got to stay sharp. How are you doing that?
Everything is gone. It's just that I've accepted the fact that, you know, I can't do much at this point of time. I do my fitness. I try to do my fitness regime in the mornings for 1 hour. I speak with my strength and conditioning coach, my fitness coach, and basically go on a maintenance schedule. So a maintenance schedule, so I don't, you know, put on too much weight by the end of the lockdown period. And also I am, you know, physically active and doing some things. And in the recent, in the lockdown period, I've gotten back to yoga and meditation, which, you know, which I was doing as a school kid. It was in our curriculum. We had to do every day some yoga and meditation. And during my university days also, I followed it. But then, you know, since being professional and traveling here and there, I lost touch with it. But now again, I have a good chance to, you know, to practice it again. And I'm feeling really good about that.
By the way, where are you right now? Your room is, it's got a nice tone.
Yeah, I borrowed my daughter's room. I borrowed my daughter's study. This is her study. And yeah, this is her room. So, because she wanted to, yeah, watch television out there in the hall. So I said, okay, fine, you can go ahead, watch, and I'll use her room. So that's why it's more pink. I can show you a caricature of her. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Too far. This is a caricature which was drawn. You can't see it, right?
I can see it. Looks good.
Looks good. Okay, fine. So, So that's why the pink room.
How old is she?
She's 9 years old now.
And in that caricature?
She was five, 2016. So six.
Yeah. I don't think I'd be alone in wanting to know. Does she play any table tennis?
She doesn't like coming to the hall. Just for the basic fact that everybody keeps asking, when are you going to be like your father?
Right.
So she doesn't like when people talk to her that way and she doesn't show up to the hall. She wants to play with me either at my mom's house where we have a table or in the club when nobody's there. Like, she likes to play with me. She likes to play with my father, my brother, you know, like this. But she never wants to come out and play with the other kids.
Did you ever feel growing up that it was tough for you because other people had expectations? Maybe they saw you doing very well at a young age and really expected you to be like focused all the time?
I was not a great achiever as a young kid. I never played for India in a cadet or in junior category. I first played for India when I was 20 years old. So that was pretty much late. Yeah. But by 20 years old, I first played for India, but by 21, I was an Olympian. I won the Commonwealth gold medal, the first Indian to do so, and won the Indian national championships by then. So it went pretty fast from there. So,
in terms of the tipping point, was there any moment there was a switch where you felt like you conquered a fear or became clear and were able to move forward?
Yes. I was first, there was this first call for a training camp with the national team. That was the first time I was part of the national team. You know, I was way outside the team, but as a young player who could do well, they invited me. I think that training camp gave me a lot of confidence first, because every time when I saw those players who were doing well for India, I used to be like, oh, they are like very good players. They are much better players, you know. But then in that training camp, when I started to move closely with them and, you know, talk to them as friends, then I came out of my shell and I was a little bit more relaxed and I was myself. So from there, things changed a lot.
And speaking of being yourself, it just occurred to me, are you using a filter right now? You look like a teenager.
No, I'm not.
Just the shave and you're relaxed and it's the yoga maybe?
Yeah, or maybe the Oman Open win.
Oh my goodness. Wow. What a great detox. Amazing.
Oh, probably, yeah. There's less stress in life these days. I have a clear routine on every day. Spend a lot of time with family and probably that's helping, I think, the whole world.
So we got a lot of fan questions for you. I wanted to start with a handful before we get into some intense quizzing.
Okay.
The first question comes from Sharath_03. He asks on Instagram, how can I practice table tennis without a table?
Wow, that's a difficult part because table is the integral part of the sport. These days, since the lockdown has begun, I've been speaking to a lot of young kids because a lot of the coaches feel that, you know, the kids are anxious and they're losing out on their motivation and, you know, keeping in touch with the sport. So they were asking me tips about how would we, you know, stay in touch with the sport. So firstly, I said, okay, you could, you know, just play around with the ball and racket and the ball. Just do something, you know, have some trick shots or just try to continue to have the feeling with the bat, with the racket and the ball. That's very, very important. And the second thing I said is if you can look into videos of matches or training of, you know, different players, different top level players, that will also keep you engaged with the sport. You're thinking about table tennis, because if you don't have a table at home, even if you had a table at home, you need somebody to play against with, you know. So there's you could have a robo, but then after a point of time it gets boring to play with the robo, so you need somebody to do a snake or, you know, some crazy shots.
Awesome.
Yeah, so I think, yeah, it's more about, yeah, trying to keep yourself active and doing something related to the sport.
This question comes from Attentist _, asking on Instagram, can you juggle 3 table tennis balls?
Juggling with 3 balls. So yeah. I have 3 balls, yeah. Oh.
One more. Last one.
Under pressure, he nails it on the third one. Third time's a charm. Juggle.
Yeah, only 3 balls. Not more.
Is that part of your training for, like, dexterity?
No. Just have been trying it since I was young. So every time I try to play multi-ball or something, then I'm all the time, like, juggling.
You worked up a sweat juggling, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, let's see what the next question is here. Anand Dutla asks on Twitter, which people have been the biggest influences on your career and your life?
Okay. The list is pretty much long because the career is long.
Standout.
I think, the first big major influence were my father and uncle who taught me table tennis, and they are my coaches still at home here. And my mom, I think father, uncle, and mom, they helped me, you know, they introduced me to the sport of table tennis and they helped me through the journey of table tennis. As a young kid, and when I turned professional, they supported me as much as they could, both financially and morally. So I think the first part of my life, they were very big influences. And then the day I got married, I think my wife has been very, very supportive of, you know, what I've been doing. And that's the main reason why I'm still able to play on the tour. And I can leave the responsibilities of home to her. She's taking care of 2 kids. Her daughter is 9 years old. Son is 3, almost 3 now. So she's taking care of them. Kindergarten, school, you know, everything. She's really taking care completely of them. So she is a very, very major influence in my life who has helped me, you know, go take my career so long.
Okay. GSumwell85 wants to know, what is your best match in your career?
Wow. Mm-hmm. The best level I've played against a player where, you know, I've done really well is the match against Neva Koki in Qatar Open. This was in 2018 when I beat Neva Koki in the first round of Qatar Open. I beat him 4-1. I think that's by far the best match, you know, I've played in terms of quality and level. I was on top of my game. I was moving so fast. I was able to decide so quickly, you know, what I wanted to do, and that was one of the best matches I played.
Choho Hu wants to know, if you can ask anybody in the world a question, and only one question, what would the question be, and to whom?
Roger Federer. How is he so classy and so good? How does he get off those shots in every match he plays? How does there are always these 1 or 2 trick shots, or I don't know, trick shots, or this timing shots.
Yeah,
it's so fantastic when he gets them off. You know, it's really so good to watch him play. So that's something I would like to know from him.
Yeah.
Because I tried to ask Timo Boll, because he's also so good with table tennis. But he says, yeah, I don't know. I just do it. It's just so natural for him. So I'd like to check it out from Roger Federer. You know, what is he thinking about those shots, which is spectacular.
Awesome. Okay, ready for some rapid fire quiz questions?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you've got 10 questions coming in, and you have 5 seconds at most to answer each question. So, here we go. In which year did you become men's singles champion of India for the first time?
2003.
Correct.
Thank you.
Question number two. How many table tennis medals did India collect at the 2010 Commonwealth Games in New Delhi?
Wow. Five.
Ding. Correct.
Five. Yeah, correct. Because the men got three and the women got two. Yeah.
Question number three. In which year did the ITTF World Tour most recently visit India?
2017.
Nailed it.
When I played the semifinal, I lost against Harimoto.
Question number four. Which home favorite player did you beat in the 2006 Commonwealth Games men's singles final?
My best buddy, William Hensel. You know, when I won that last point and we went to shake hands, he hugged me first. And I said, well played, very bad luck to him. And he said, you deserve to win today. You know, I still remember those words when he said, because if I had lost a match that close, I would more be like, okay, fine, yeah. Well done, awesome. But then he gave it to me, saying that you deserve to win today. So it was really magnanimous from him to say that at that point of time. So
yeah. Who is the only table tennis player from outside of China and Korea Republic to win an Olympic gold medal?
Outside. No. I don't know the answer.
I'll give you a hint. He's the Mozart of table tennis.
Oh, Wallner. Sorry.
It's okay. Four for five.
Said, yeah.
Not bad. Okay. Question number six. How old was Tomokazu Harimoto when he became the youngest ITTF World Tour Grand Final men's singles champion in 2018?
14.
And 15.
No! I thought he never grew up because he's always this 13-year-old kid. He just graduated from high school recently.
He beat Timo at 14 for the Czech Open. That was, tricky question. Okay, four for six. Question seven. What city was ITTF originally founded in?
All this. Well, you had it in... Austria, Vienna, Switzerland? No. ITTF was founded in... Was it founded in England?
It was not. The first World Championships was in London in 1926, but it was founded in Berlin.
Berlin. Ah, okay. I didn't know that.
Alrighty, no problem. Four for seven. General knowledge category.
Mm-hmm.
In which city is the 2008 film Slumdog Millionaire set?
Mumbai.
Ding, ding, ding. Correct. Question number nine. Who is the top-selling musical artist or group of all time?
Michael Jackson.
Number seven. Number one. One more guess.
One more time, the question. Please repeat the question.
Who is the top-selling musical artist or group of all time?
Wow. If it's not Michael Jackson, then... I don't know.
The Beatles.
The Beatles. Oh, okay.
Okay. And last but not least, you're on five right now.
Mm.
What is the capital city of Senegal?
I was with Diab Ibrahim during the photo shooting, and he told me the name of the Adi Go ahead.
Dakar.
Yes.
Yeah. I know because of Iba.
Yes, we spoke about it. We spoke about it, and yeah, I somehow.
Not too bad. You set a good standard so far. 5 out of 10. We'll see how others do when they compete in the home edition of Ask a Pro Anything presented by Andro. But not a bad start. So, Sharath, you won a title in 2020 over a very strong opponent, a recent world top 10, Marcos Freitas, in Oman. That was your first title in 10 years. And that's quite an impressive lifespan as a table tennis player. Can you take us back to the moments of the Egypt Open in 2010 and what that was like for you?
At that point of time, I saw the greatest, the newest heights in my career. I just had recently won the US Open before coming into Egypt Open. So just a week before, I beat Kenyatta Thomas in the final of US Open. So I had a lot of confidence into the tournament. And then at Egypt Open, that was my first title. I was 27. I turned 28 in that tournament. We were there for my birthday. I still remember. So one of very memorable victories at that point of time. I won the tournament, I had my career best ranking of 38 at that point of time. I still remember that. You in the background you see Massimo Constantini sitting behind there. His best ranking was 39 and I became 38. So yeah, he was really happy about that. So that was the first time I won. And then it took me another 10 years from there to win one more title. So it's been really long. But I'm really happy I could win these two titles, especially Oman Open, beating Marcos Freitas, who is a really tough opponent for me.
Recently, again, right now, you're at an age that some players have long retired, but you seem to be in sharp, sharp form. What do you think was to credit for such a strong performance in Oman?
This was the preparation for the 2020 Olympic Games. You know, I started preparing in November for the Olympic qualifiers, which is supposed to happen in April in Bangkok. But all the events have been suspended now. And for the Olympic Games. So I wanted to give this Olympic Games my best shot because I'm really in very good shape, both physically and mentally. And I think this is the best chance I would have at the Olympic Games, even though it's the fourth Olympic Games I'm going to play in. So that was the main reason, I started preparing for the tournaments. And I could clearly see that I was shaping up. I was peaking at the right time. I was coming into a good form. Already at the Olympic qualifiers, World Team Olympic qualifiers in Portugal. And then, I was really happy that I could win this match against Marcos Freitas. You see, the coach here is also very fixed. Very, very happy there. Brett Clark from Australia.
17-15 in game number 6. What a victory. Well, really exciting to see you playing in such outstanding form right now. And I think it's inspiring because, one, it just reminds us that, age is nothing but a number. And if you're disciplined, if you're determined, you can find that your peak has yet to come. So we're looking forward to seeing more of you and to continue upward and onward.
True, true, very true. As you said, age is just a number. If Vladdy is able to do that, so it's really fantastic. He's taking on the Chinese even at this age. So,
All right, we have a few more fan questions I wanted to ask you. Koshin_Z_ wants to know, what are your views on Timo Boll copying your bandana?
I was really surprised. I think I was very, very surprised that he started to have the banana. But then it looks pretty cool and pretty nice. I think there was also a question, which a lot of players ask, what's the thing with your headband? So it's more or less like earlier in 2004, 2005, I used to have long hair. So I started playing with the bandana, and that was how the trend was. Every most of the sports persons all over the world, not just in, tennis was very popular, but in many sports, they were playing with the bandana. So I also wanted to have that style. And once I won the Commonwealth Games in 2006, everybody started to ask, you are the guy with that thing on your head. You know, they don't know what's that, but that thing on your head, yeah. So it became my trademark, and I thought I'll keep it as my identity. So even though now I don't have any hair, I still, short hair, I still keep the bandana on.
All right. Let's see what this next question is here. Sachin Uchil wants to know, would you like to go into coaching after you retire as an athlete?
Well, a lot of people have asked me this question, what I'm going to do after I'm retiring. I will stay with the sport. I haven't decided if I will be a coach or somebody in the administration or take a high performance director post or something like this. But I will give it back to the sport because I have a lot of experience which I've gained through my long career, and it needs to be passed on. Otherwise, again, we'll have to the younger players who are trying to come up into the world circuit, they will again have no guidance, or they will be lost in the way. So if somebody like me can still stay on in the game and help these young kids, India can develop faster. That's my opinion.
Cool. Now, I didn't want to end with thinking about you retiring, because I know I'm not alone in not wanting to have to think about that. And I think hopefully and fortunately you're in incredible shape. So hopefully we have you for a really long time. And a follow-up question is from Nachiketa Guha, what's your secret to your longevity?
Well, I think the main thing is my fitness. I think physically I've kept myself quite fit and kept myself going. And I've got I don't know how I got it, but I've generally got a lot of discipline in my life, and that is helping me, extend my career as much as possible. Also, I had a major injury in 2015 in World Championships against Simon Gauzy when I tore my hamstring. So after that, I thought I would have to end my career. But then I could recover fine from that. And it took me nearly 8 months before I could come back to the level where I was playing, or at least not come back, at least play to a certain high level, table tennis. So I think at that point of time, again, trying to be fit and coping up with the young players had helped me keep my game my career going on for a long process.
Yeah. Little fun fact about that match where you tore your hamstring. I was commentating it. And for those of you that don't know, Sharath played on injury and still won the match against Simon Gauzy. That was crazy.
Yeah, true. That was really crazy. My doctor was like, he was yelling at me, just stop now and get out of the court. I said, please give me one more set, one last set.
And you stood near the table and you finished the points quickly, and it was so uncomfortable for Simon Gauzy. Man, that was interesting to watch. Good fight. The fighting spirit of Sharath Kamal Achanta. So Sharath, it's been a lot of fun talking to you. Anything you want to say to your fans?
Firstly, thank you very much, ITTF and Adam, for giving me this opportunity. I think for the fans during this, especially during the lockdown period and all of us staying home, and we don't know when ITTF will be able to do the activities. I think it's very important to stay positive, looking forward into doing something every day, trying to be physically active and trying to be motivated. So I think this is the best time to take up your hobbies and or spend more time with family, because I don't know if we will get this kind of a chance one more time in our lives. So I think we should make best use of it.
Awesome and wise words. Good inspiration. So there you have it. Sharath Kamal Achanta, the first episode of the at-home edition of Ask a Pro Anything, presented by Andro. Thank you so much for doing this, and hopefully we'll be seeing each other on the world tour soon enough instead of just social media. But great to see you, Sharath.
Thank you. Thank you, Adam. Thank you very much.
Take care.
Yeah.